Hello guys, as you may already know, my name is Denis and you are watching Close to Algo Trading. I'm still dealing with the deep learning trading system. And this video should be very interesting, because I'll show you my fails. Actually, I spent a lot of time trying to implement everything using only TensorFlow, but I am really disappointed with the quality of that library. I like the concept, but I hate the documentation that TensorFlow provides. It looks like all those PhDs could not just write a normal structured documentation. Yes, it's better than it used to be, but still confusing at so many points. Well, documentation is a small problem. The big issue is, there is a lot of functions which are not working if you try to use them. Moreover, sometimes they don't work in official examples. But maybe I am missing some core points of this framework. Anyway, let me go back to the topic of this video. My fails. As you may remember, I choose to generate labels of a price movement in a specified percentage. Actually, most of our labels are just local minimum and maximums. After some simple data processing and preparation, I created a simple LTSM network and tried. My expectation was not really big, but what I got was totally disappointing. As you can see in the picture, the network doesn't learn anything. Well, a neural network is not supposed to make miracles, and maybe it is worth thinking about our approach. Our events represent only 2% of all data of the dataset. We can say they are outliers, and our simple network could not distinguish those events from others. Also, there is a high probability that our events have nothing in common with each other, and their causes seem to be completely different. In this case, it will be really difficult to make a network that will predict such events. We really need to concentrate on understanding the data, find features which could have a prediction power. Thinking about it, I decide to go back to the roots and try a simple moving average strategy. Well, in the first approach, we didn't have any idea why we should enter into the position. Now, we already have a strategy for opening positions. Our strategy is still not very good, but as long as it's very popular, let's use it. As you can see, I added two moving averages and RSI indicator to our dataset and collected all events where the moving averages crosses each other. So, now we have the estimated price movement direction. Well, let's create meta labels using the same method as earlier. But now, we will not label the complete dataset, but only bars where the moving averages crosses each other. Here we have one important difference from the previous case. Since we already have the knowledge about the position direction, long or short, the meaning of our labels will differ. We will set label to 1 in case of profit and minus 1 in case of loss, and 255 in other cases. Well, I created a simple LTSM model again, put all the data into the model, and got a perfect ROC curve. ROC curve. Receiver operating characteristic curve is a graph showing the performance of a classification model at all classification thresholds. AUC stands for area under the ROC curve. ROC, IUC curves help us select the best model by evaluating how well a model distinguishes between classes. It's unexpected. Let's check what our model predicts. We can see that the model always predicts class 0. It happens because I again took the whole dataset, not only events. So our dataset is still imbalanced, and our feature don't have prediction ability. As we can see, ROC curve are not the best choice for imbalanced datasets. The model doing well making classifications for a specific class, and hide the fact that the model does poorly predicting other classes. So, let's fix the imbalance in the data and go to our final fail. After fixing our dataset and leaving only the data which are relevant to our open events, I trained my model and got something that we could expect. Our model doesn't have any predictive power. We got the same result as from the random model. I also made a simple feedforward model, and this model shows a bit better result, but still garbage. So, as you can see, there is no magic in the deep learning if you try to fit your model with bad data. After all of this, we really can say garbage in, garbage out. Also, and it's not the least important point, if your dataset is highly imbalanced and you don't have features that have strong predictive power, your classification model will mostly predict the class that makes up the biggest part of the dataset. As I told earlier, we need to understand our data and processes which can help us find a possibility to beat the market. So guys, have a nice time, stay home and be healthy. Bye!